Brett Douglas, Peace and Love Reaction Channel. So I do something called a retraction reaction. It's when someone might tell me that I should check something out again, maybe, and like I was wrong about something, or I didn't know something, like the case here. I didn't know that this was about Morissette's, like, probably the, like, biggest, most emotional decision she ever had to make. And let's look at the comments. But, I look insane. Okay. So, okay, and she currently co-writes with her husband. Okay, that features songs. Okay, awesome. Morissette works under Dog Music and has other collaborations with Star Music. Okay, what song is part of her original signature EP, which she co-wrote with Dave Lamar and now her husband? Hi, Brett, that was Morissette's own song created just to convey the message to her father. There's a music video of that song. I wish I could watch the music video, but it will copyright me in a heartbeat unless I blur the whole thing. Here's the best performances of her recent originals. She wrote this regarding the estrangement from her family, and particularly her father. They had issues with her husband, who's an amazing man. Yeah, so it's kind of an ultimative correction. She said someday. Yep, great reaction. Marcos thought it was a breakup song, but then he saw honest reaction. Brett, we'll stay next, please. Arnold, thank you. You know, I've lost a lot of subscribers and a lot of people that liked my channel, because sometimes I'm just not feeling a song, and why would you want to listen to someone that's just gonna pretend like he loves something when he doesn't love something. Now, I liked this song. Now that I know what it's about, I do like to do two reactions. And one reaction is, the first is about the song structure. Not just the song structure, but the melody, the song structure, and also the beat, and just everything about the song, except for the lyrics and the story, which I'm going to break down now. But I also, if you noticed, at the 2 minute mark when the refrain came in, I was totally feeling the song after that. So let's break down these lyrics, guys. So love you still, even though you made me choose between the love of my life and my family, I love you still. But that's just, wow. And I heard that kind of the love of her life and music was kind of on that side too. Like, he didn't want her to do music. Is that true? Sometimes I hear it in my dreams. 100% different feeling now that I know what it's about. 100% different. So, wow.
Your vision haunting me, this feeling so uneasy, caught somewhere in the in-between.
In between, she's in the middle, and that's where they put her. What do I do with these memories of you? How do I keep them from changing color every time? Everything's constantly fading. Again, I say this, but this is the first time I'm going to say this with the Morissette fans. Great songwriters, great storytellers, they don't worry about the rhyme. It's not, what do I do with these memories of you? It's like you're throwing shoe. Like, you're not thinking of the rhyme. People do that. No, you tell the story and the rhymes come. Like, really, this verse right here doesn't technically rhyme, but listen to how, I don't even remember it, but I know that it's going to sound like it does.
What do I do?
Doesn't rhyme, doesn't matter, because story first. No one's gonna notice. You don't sit there and say changing color. Father and mother. So I give this to you, father and mother. No, if you tell a story, the rhymes will come. Why do I sleep for 4 days straight and then sit there for another 4 days and lay awake? Am I bipolar? Yes, but I'm not suicidal. I am the arrival of the show that's... Don't think of the rhyme. I am the arrival of the new breath. And your rival. I'm mixing the old me with the new me. Okay.
Everything's constantly fading, still hoping and waiting that someday I'd hear you call.
But really, everyone loses because of the hurt that she feels, and you would assume that the family feels too. Completely different feeling about the song now that I know what it's about. Now I understand why she stretched out the intro, stretched out the verses, and then held off on bringing the refrain in. Now it makes sense to me. Also, now you guys know that I'm going to be honest with you, because I was iffy about the song before, but now it's freaking amazing. I love this song. This is going to be a song that I will... It'll be a go-to song when I feel like I have to make a decision and I'm going to hurt either way, but I have to think about, you know, what's right and what's going to make me happy. Think of me and sit down for coffee. she made them rhyme. That's awesome that she was able to do that. But this is the simpleness. Her dad gets up apparently and drinks coffee in the morning. Do you still think of me when you sit down for coffee? Do you still long to have me near? This is so deep. You know, this is just real, real music right here.
Do you still long to have me near? I'm drowning underneath. How do you breathe so lightly? At least that's how it seems.
How do you breathe so lightly? How are you able to live life so easily? And, you know, I'm a wreck, but you seem to be just fine. At least that's how it seems to be. And Moore says that might not, that I'm assuming that's not true. I know that he's hurting inside. I don't know when this all happened. Was this like 5-6 years ago? You know, this is kind of a second refrain that she's got here. I think she changes her voice right here, if I can remember correctly. Okay, this is where she changes her voice. I love when she comes in and changes her voice like this. It's kind of like a cappella. It's like a room of people, you know, talking, and then all of a sudden everyone stops talking and all we hear is her.
If we came face to face, I wouldn't know what to say. But my eyes would give it all away. I still love you. Still. I still love you. Still. I still love you. Still. I still love you.
What an epic, beautiful outro right there. All that stuff happening at the same time. Just amazing. Just amazing. I'm so glad I did a retraction reaction for this song. Breathtaking, amazing, amazing, amazing. What a difference it makes when a song is something that you made, or she made, that she put her heart into. I always say, I would rather hear somebody that is a songwriter that's singing about their life and their struggles, and they're a decent singer, then an amazing singer have someone write something for them. Now, Morissette is one of the top singers in the world. She could be the top. I'm not sure. because I guess I haven't done enough research, but is there anyone that's touching her? I mean, she's the best at covers, and now I'm going down the path of original. Sorry, 15 minutes, but you know what? This is a retraction, reaction, and lyric breakdown. So this is different than a reaction. So there's going to be a lot more pauses. You know, you guys, you don't have to watch. But the main thing is I am retracting my reaction. Where I said it was good, not great. It was great. It was epic. It was emotional. I got teary-eyed. I'm not going to tell you when. Well, I was kind of in the middle, at the beginning, and at the end. Guys, thank you so much for letting me into your lives. I'm a good person. You know, I actually died. I was legally dead for 2 minutes, came back to life, and, you know, God brought me back to life for a reason, and we're going to find out together what that reason is. Peace and love. I'm Brett Douglas. I'll see you in the next reaction.